This election, New Mexico voters are once again being asked to change the state constitution in an effort to reform the Public Regulation Commission. The PRC, as we know it, has been beset by scandal and inefficiency since it was created in the late 1990s. And previous attempts to reform and professionalize the five-member elected panel have had, Steve, mixed results. It would become an appointed body of three, as we know. Do you think that's a better move and that the elected PRC has run its course?
Well, not to violate my secret ballot, but I voted for the amendment. I've covered the PRC for several years, and yeah, sometimes it just seemed hopeless. It's like political pie fights, and not only that, and behind the scenes, they for years had this problem with all these vacancies, division heads, and other important administrative jobs have just been unfilled. And so it's just, it's been a mess. I think this would be better. There've been efforts to do this for, since I started covering the legislature, actually back in 2000. I think it would be more efficient and less, it's such a technical thing. And people say, well, we need the power to vote for our commissioners. You know, that's a down ballot position. A lot of people out in the public really don't know what the PRC does. And so if they just vote for their favorite politician, nothing's going to change.
Did you pick up on that? It's, you know, the idea here is to take politics out of the game. One of the ideas is not to have, out of the three members, two cannot be of the party of that sitting governor, if I have that right. Does that strip out all politics, or is this just another way to get around certain things?
No, I think it would increase the political factor. And I will, in the interest of full disclosure, say that I voted against this because I think with all the problems of the PRC that were described by Steve, these are staffing problems, these are technical problems, and having the commission appointed rather than elected would not solve those problems. They are staffing problems. And what we are left with then would be a body that is totally unaccountable to anyone but the New Mexico Senate and the governor. And my experience has been that sometimes having an independent PRC that can act at best in the interests of the ratepayers, that might be better than having the legislature and the governor control it. I'm also resentful of the fact that the question on the ballot does not actually say to the voters, you are removing elected body and replacing it with an appointed body.
Right.
That is the case. And I think that people need to know that their power is being diminished in that way. And the accountability of these folks that are performing a very important, making very important decisions will be subject to the legislature, which now is, they are campaign contributions are not restricted a half as much as those for the PRC. PRC commissioners cannot take contributions from regulated industries. Legislators, governors certainly can.
That's an interesting point there, something to keep in mind. And Tom, Didi mentioned something that is just, you know, representation is a very precious thing for a lot of folks. You're talking about a bedrock, fundamental part of being in a democracy, basically. And how does this get pitched to the public that it's a better system than what we had before?
Yeah, and since everybody's doing disclosures, I have not voted, but in disclosure, I do have clients who will sometimes find themselves in front of the PRC. My comments are my own. And so with that, I think the issue of representation is very key because, you know, we have, for example, the Albuquerque Bernalillo County Water Utility Authority. And these water utility authorities, you know, do not have any elected bodies on there. You know, they have a lot of elected folks who are representing supposedly, the general public. But I fear that the types of proposed changes that we're seeing for the PRC with that constitutional amendment will take away that representation because and it will create just an even more politicized body. Granted, you know, the dysfunction that we've seen at the PRC is pretty epic. Mm-hmm. But, I don't think that it's reason to blow it up. I think there's a reason to really focus and help them to be more deliberate and professional in their dealings.
Mm-hmm. There's another good government topic I want to get to, the latest lobbying report by New Mexico Ethics Watch, which detailed $2.3 million from lobbyists given to legislative campaigns. A full third of that was given by Chevron. And Steve, more than 94% of contributions from oil and gas lobbyists come from out of state. Right now, what was your read on as you saw this initial report? What was your sense of it?
Oh yeah, I didn't realize that much money was coming in from out of state, but it is, and it's an incredible thing. And this is a time where a lot of people are suffering financially because of the pandemic and the shutdowns and everything. Just to see these big oil companies. In this case, it was Chevron was like the star of the show. Just basically look at the appearances they're trying to buy the state government. Mm-hmm. And but they can, I've hardly ever written campaign finance campaign contributions for, $300,000 or whatever. It just seems obscene the amount of money that pours in. It's not illegal, and they're sure. doing everything right. And I got to say, Chevron's really good about filling out complete, campaign disclosure forms and everything, and lobbyist disclosure forms. Mm-hmm. They abide by the law. But
let me get Dee Dee in here. Sorry to cut you off, Steve. Just got about a minute left. Dee Dee, you've been active in this realm of the world. What was your sense of it as you read that report?
Well, this is a time of peril for the oil and gas industry, mm-hmm. and their revenues have been diminished. And yet here they are spending huge megabucks on lobbying and the legislature in particular. I think it's not just Chevron. It's also Conoco,
right.
ConocoPhillips, Occidental. And you have to take all of those contributions together. Mm-hmm. Thank God we have some measure of transparency. And as Steve said, I think, Chevron is disclosing. There are a lot of candidates and a lot of others that do not disclose, either by accident mm-hmm. or, careful perusal of the reports will. Steve was telling me about one thing.
Got to cut you there. Sorry about that. Just a little bit on short on time. Thanks to everyone on our panel. Also, go vote. We'll see you back at this table soon.